Wow. In this video, number one, let's talk about porn poverty. You're investing in porn, whether you know it or not. I'm going to show you how. And then number two, let's contemplate together how much you're investing and why you're investing so much in porn. And then number three is your brain hack for the day. How you can invest your resources somewhere else so you can thrive. All right, let's dig in. Number one, does porn really create poverty in your life? Absolutely. Yes, it does. Now, what are your riches? Let's think of this. What are your resources? What are the things that would make you a rich man? Well, my resources and what I consider to be everybody else's are our time, our energy, and our money. Time, energy, money. Those are our primary resources. So if you're investing your primary resources, your time, your money, and most importantly, your energy, especially your neural brain energy, if you're investing that in porn, you in fact are creating poverty in your life by investing yourself into the wrong thing. Now, why is it the wrong thing? Because we know from neuroscience that porn damages your brain. It decreases function in your frontal lobe. It desensitizes the reward center in your brain, which makes it so that you aren't as aroused with your partner. It creates relationship problems. It creates anxiety, depression, lack of motivation, brain fog, ADHD-like symptoms. It creates erectile dysfunction. It gives you a whole host of problems. So it's something that you invest in that gives you poor returns. So don't get me wrong, in the moment you might feel good, but if we're looking at return on investment, ROI, your ROI for porn is low. So it's creating poverty. It is taking your time, your energy, and probably your money, and it is not giving you the return on investment. It's not making your brain work better. It's not making your relationships better. It's not making your work better. It's not making you feel less stressed and less bored in your life, except for when you're in the screen. It is taking from you. It's creating the issues in your life. Porn's creating the poverty that you feel in your time, your energy levels, and probably your money. Okay, so number two, let's think about why are you investing so much in porn? And how are you doing that? So you're investing by spending your time, your energy, and your money. Look at your schedule. So we're gonna contemplate this together. Get your journal out and look at your schedule and look at how much time you actually spend consuming pornography. Then let's back it up a notch and let's look at, contemplate, write down, process, and integrate how much time you think about porn or you think about sex. Now we know hypersexuality or compulsive sexual behavior disorder, it shows up as thinking about sex a lot, possibly all the time. So that is your time and your energy. So think about that. How much are you investing in it? Now, why are you investing in it? Whether you know it or not, porn is a self-soothing behavior. You're using it to soothe discomfort. So clearly the solution is to be able to get better at dealing with discomfort and taking the discomfort out of your life and being able to deal with the less discomfort that you still have, because the human condition can be an uncomfortable one, but figuring out a way to deal with it in a healthy way. So you won't have to self-soothe. If you decrease the discomfort and you learn how to deal with it better, you won't need to escape into porn to get away from the discomfort. That is the primary mechanism that porn is used for: stress reduction, getting away from the uncomfortable feelings of difficult emotions like stress. Secondarily, the difficult emotion of boredom. But honestly, porn creates the boredom because you train your brain to go into the screen to feel good, but it feels worse when you're outside of the screen. So if you didn't go into the screen, your actual life would be filled with hobbies and with things that you love. So filling your life with things that you love makes it so that you don't have to go into the screen and you can fill your life with riches again. You can spend your time on the things that fill you up and actually create great relationships, create good work, create fun in the real world. That's what I'm talking about. That's how you become a rich man quick, by coming out of the screen and getting into your life and filling your life in a wonderful way. My husband and I joke, because our life is a very busy life, and instead of calling it a busy life, because busy doesn't feel good, right? Who wants to be busy all the time? Not me. I call it a full life. My life is full. I have 6 beautiful children around me, and I get to help them grow up. That's a full life. I have a wonderful business that I totally love working on, and I love helping you, whether you know it or not. I love showing up here to be able to help you. This fills me up. I've created a nonprofit, pornbrainprevention.org. Feel free to donate. That is filling me up. I'm going upstream. I'm going to try to help teenagers never start watching porn. That gets me out of bed, gets my feet on the floor every morning in a charged up way. It's a full life. Then I get to go hang out with my besties and dance poorly and rock out to 80s music that Chanel inevitably puts on. And it's fun. And we get to sit in the cone of silence. I told you about this before. She has this super swanky wine cellar in her basement. And you close the doors and the dudes will be on the outside and the ladies, the girls will be in the cone of silence. We can say whatever we want. My husband said the other night, "What were you guys talking about in there?" I'm like, "Nothing." Because I was just cracking up. We're cracking up with each other. We're having a good time just being with each other. Spice of life. That's the secret sauce right there. That's the riches. People that you want to be with, work you love doing, and hobbies and things that you enjoy. I just got a new juicer. Yep, I know what you're thinking. A juicer, Trish, this is your new hobby. It's super cool. I'm juicing kale and cucumber and celery. It tastes like absolute garbage, but it's got beautiful antioxidants in it. And I've got the whole fam squad checking out how this juicer works until I jammed it up because I put twice as much kale in it as you're supposed to. No worries. We extracted that kale, put half as much in. We're back to juicing because I like to eat healthy and that's important to me. I'm bringing everybody into the joy of juicing. You can do those things too. It's not like you have to sign up for something and go to it 10 times a week. You can get yourself a juicer and start juicing some kale. And before you know it, you got a cool another thing that you're thinking about in your life. You become rich. And by the way, I bought a very affordable juicer, a Black & Decker. It was $49 because I'm like, I am not buying an expensive juicer unless juicing is still part of my life in a month. And if it is, then I'll get myself a little bougier version so that it's easier to juice. But you can do that. You can think, okay, what things are important to me? What do I like? How do I include it in an affordable way to get started today? You can do that and you become a rich man. You become a rich person when you do that. Okay, now let's move on to 3, which I know I've already moved into, is what can you invest instead in? So just like return on investment, when you figure out what work you were meant to do on this earth innately, it might not be the work that you are doing. And I've told you this before, I was a college professor for a long time and I liked it. I just never felt like this was it for me. So I kept feeling this discomfort of needing to move forward. And here I am living the authentic life that I want. I found my way into my purpose by not giving up. And by having the courage to leave that position when I just got tenured and promoted, I never saw one dime of the big chunk of change that I was promoted because I moved on into the purpose, into the thing that was calling me. I had the courage to do that. You have to have courage. You have to show up in the face of fear and be able to move forward. I invested my time and my energy into myself and my money. I didn't take that money from that position. I took the money I had and said, no, I'm going to make this business of my own, drtrishleigh.com. And here I am. Because I had the courage to do that, I invested my time, my energy, and my money into me. That's what I want you to do. Think about how you can do it in your work, in your relationships, and in your hobbies. If you start doing that today, you're not going to need porn. You're going to be a rich man in the world, and you won't have to go back into the screen. All right, if you're looking for help on that journey, reach out to me, drtrishleigh.com. I have, on purpose and intentionally, I have programs of different shapes and sizes to be able to serve your resources, to serve the amount of time, the amount of energy, and the amount of money you have to put into this right now. I have all different levels very deliberately to help you today to get started. All right. And as always, until next time, control your brain or it'll control you.